Meet Deputy Mubarak. He's new to the agency, sworn in on April 2nd, 2021.
I'm grateful for this opportunity and I look forward to serving this beautiful community.
Thank you very much. He's going through the field training process and I have every belief he's going to be successful and be a value to our agency and to our community.
Mubarak was born in eastern Afghanistan. He immigrated here about 13 years ago. Before his current role at the Sheriff's Office, he worked with the Army and Marine Corps. His father encouraged both he and his brother to become interpreters for the U.S. military.
He wanted me not only to be a linguist, but also be some kind of, you know, bridge between the Americans and the local people. With interpretation, obviously, it's not only the actual interpretation, but it's also, you know, the cultural elements that come in and affect the whole thing.
For several years, he served alongside the U.S. Special Forces, assisting in securing high-level intelligence. He specifically worked alongside former Marine Colonel Randy Hoffman, the sheriff's cousin.
I realized within a month that this was an extremely valuable person. On several occasions, more than 10, I'm sure his decision not only saved my life, but saved the life of other Special Forces operators.
Because of his work overseas, he was granted citizenship in the U.S. He brought his wife and kids to the States and began his journey at Fort Bragg in North Carolina. He later spent time in Quantico, Virginia, 29 Palms, California, Camp Pendleton, and Indiana.
In 29 Palms, my main job was basically teaching the basic language, Dari and Pashto, and also teaching operational culture.
He's been on deployment in southern Afghanistan, earned his master's degree in Central Eurasian Studies, and even became a graduate teaching assistant.
I am an active member of this community, and I always wanted to be among the people, and I always wanted to be in a position where I can contribute more to the community.
He's a man who served his nation, our nation, and now is serving our local community. But now, Mubarak is the one who needs help. Due to the recent Taliban takeover, Mubarak's family was in danger.
And I was very fearful for them, and because I was well known in the area, and it would be a very quick, you know, action for them to go after my sisters and my brother and nephews and nieces.
That's when Sheriff Kurt Hoffman stepped in, doing what he could to get Mubarak's family to safety.
It's been kind of a full court press. We've enlisted Senator Rick Scott's office. We've reached out to the Marine Corps. We've reached out to the State Department. And fortunately, his family was able to make it onto the airport after several attempts of trying to get past Taliban checkpoints.
33 out of 34 of Deputy Mubarak's family members are now in Fort Bliss in Texas.
I am a new deputy, and I feel honored and privileged that our sheriff is going out to do everything to help a new member of this community.
Why go through all that trouble to make this happen?
I think it's well known in this agency that I come from a Marine Corps family, and Deputy Mubarak served with the Marine Corps, specifically with my cousin. And I don't think it's a stretch to say save my cousin's life and a lot of other Marines. So it seemed like the right thing to do for somebody who had risked their life for our country and frankly for his country, trying to make it better.
Because of Mubarak's work with Special Forces and the imminent danger to his family, they are being processed with special immigrant visas through the U.S. State Department.
It happened quick. We're trying to explore different options so we can have smooth transition for them and beginning a new life.
Their next stop, Sarasota. And with nothing but the clothes on their backs, they need our help.
We've been working diligently the last few days to get a GoFundMe page up. They're going to need a lot of assistance when they get here. As you can imagine, there's going to be a culture shock. We're going to need housing, clothing, food. They are a hard-working people, as is Deputy Mubarak. They're already asking about jobs. So I know this community. I've lived here for 40 years. They will rally and they will support us. And I hope they go to that GoFundMe page and put a few dollars in there for a guy who has stood with our military for a number of years and protected our military. Now it's our turn to give back and help his family.
When I first came to the States, I wish I knew how big the American dream was, how big the opportunities we have here in the States were, and I'm glad, you know, I have that now, and I'll be able to share that with them, and so I'm very excited to see them, and once again I'm grateful for the Sheriff's Office help and assistance. And I hope that we'll be able to, you know, get help and assistance from our community members.
Mubarak hasn't been here for long, but he's already family, and family helps each other out.